there's a quote, and the quote is, those who do with hands are laborers, those who do with hands and mind are craftsmen, and those who do with hands, mind, and heart are artists. What influences my work, and it's been consistent for years. I think in the beginning, it was the people around me and technique and chasing down technique and how good I could get with hair. And after you kind of conquer those basic things, or you feel like you have, it becomes about suitability. And that brings us to the individual in the chair. So for me, it's always that. They're the jumping off point. They're the one that says, I love my hair like this, or I don't like this. It's technique falls behind that. But I think it's being a good listener, having empathy for the person in the chair, and figuring out who they are or who they want to be. And I've found great joy in helping somebody find themselves in their look. And for me, if I kind of really be that person that connects, I think connectability is the key to that. Connectability helps you make that perfect match between haircut and person. I think creativity is an evolution of ideas. And I think you have to be also very curious all the time to collect those ideas. So you always have loads of them. And whether they're in your head or in your phone, in visuals, or written down. I write a lot. I write when I think, I journal. And in the moment in time when I need something, it's always there. My mom has 7 sisters, 3 of them were hairdressers. And I was very close with one. She was a hairdresser, the coolest person I knew at the time. And I wanted to be like her. So I started in hairdressing. And I started in her salon, actually. There, at that salon, I learned what salon life was. And I learned all the assets to make a successful salon, all the things, and I trained up in everything. And hair cutting actually was the thing that made me think I need more. It was the one thing that frustrated me most. And I wanted to do better at it. I was in the salon about 5 years, and the frustration of not knowing how to get the looks the way I wanted brought me to New York City, and I went to Sassoon. And I started my career over as an assistant. The first day of my class there, I remember the creative director then at the time, he said, if you hold the hair out like this and you let it go, it's gonna fall here and it's gonna do that every single time. And he held the hair out here and he let it go and it fell just as he said. And at that point I was hooked. I'm like, this is it, this is the place to be. Most of the influences were the people around me. Well, my aunt to start, because she was the protagonist of my career. She got me into hairdressing and the idea of being a hairdresser. And then when I moved to Sassoon, it was the city itself, New York City, amazing place, so inspirational for so many things. But it was the people that I was surrounded with, and everybody from the assistants to the creative team to the international team. Who they were, where they traveled, the clothes they wear, the things they were into. That really was so inspiring to me. I knew I wanted to teach right away. Being an educator in a cosmetology school or being an educator for beginners is a great career. I think it's super rewarding to connect to someone and to inspire them to do what you do. There's nothing like it. And you can grow so much. Most of my growth in hairdressing was as a teacher, for sure. And I thought I knew it, and then I taught it, and I'm like, whoa, now I know it better. And that keeps going and never stops. I've come full circle now. When I started teaching, I started in cosmetology school at Al Sassoon in Santa Monica, and I honed hair design, but not just hair design. I honed teaching and leadership as well. And I have enough experience now and brought myself to a level that I feel so confident in that it's time to give back. Because now my focus is the beginner learner again. to continue to elevate the industry one student at a time. That is a focus for Aveda Arts. That is a mission of ours, and I get to lead that. Teacher training, I think, is really important. I think the beginners need a higher level of experience with them, next to them, teaching them. So not just having a set curriculum that everybody comes in and everybody follows and then they leave, but a set curriculum that individual can become confident within themselves. And before they leave the school, we can help guide them in the direction they actually want to go, because the industry is so vast. And I think that's really important at the beginning, that student leaves the school having an understanding of a direction they want to go. Might not be the one that they want to end up with, but a direction that'll keep them in the industry. Hairdressing is a craft, which means it can be honed, it could be leveled up, you could be very successful in it. I wish I knew then what I know now. I really do. I wish somebody said to me it could be so entrepreneurial, because I don't think that was ever a conversation. I think when I started in hairdressing, I thought I'd be a hairdresser behind the chair. I never knew that with one scissor, one comb, I'd travel the world. I think it's a great career for people that are forever learners. If you get the beginning right, the rest is fantastic. I always think for myself, I'm not sure what others think, but I think for myself what I'd like is that to know that I had a small hand in elevating the industry as a whole. A small hand.